How can we become a new creation through the grace of baptism? What would happen if you are immersed in the water? Inside water, you cannot breathe. You cannot take in oxygen into your lungs. Now, you lose your oxygen source. You try to come up to the surface to take in oxygen. You can no longer hold your breath. Water fills up your insides. You will start drowning, and if you don't come up, there is the danger of dying due to suffocation. When we come to the baptism, it also has a meaning of plunging in, being immersed or dipped. As we go into the water, we experience death to our all nature. And when we come out of water, we experience Christ's resurrection. And we come out as a new creation. When one goes into the baptismal waters, it is not only just washing away of sin. There, we die to our all sinful nature. We allow our old sinful lives to die. Then we emerge out of water with the new life in Jesus Christ. This is what St. Paul says in his letter to the Romans, chapter 6. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too may walk in the newness of life. Today, we celebrate the feast of the baptism of the Lord. In the Holy Gospel, we recognize how Jesus Christ entered into the waters of baptism. Why did Jesus come for baptism in the waters of River Jordan? The first thing that God created was the waters. Book of Genesis also says that the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Here, waters symbolize creation. Due to the original sin of man, the whole creation was tainted by sin. The waters represent the first creation. Therefore, Christ chose to be baptized in the water in order to represent the sanctification of the whole creation. On the other hand, Jesus didn't get baptized to purify himself. He was already sinless and holy. Rather, Jesus wanted to be in solidarity with us. Christ's baptism means he is with us and he is one of us. In baptism, we follow the steps of Jesus Christ when we are immersed in the water, just like Jesus Christ. We spiritually enter the tomb of Jesus and we leave our sin behind. Then we rise again with a new life in Christ. We become a new creation and we begin a new journey. As Jesus comes out of the waters, we hear the acclamation of the Father. This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. In order to become a beloved son, a beloved daughter of God, we have to become a new creation. Now, let us turn towards ourselves. We became a beloved son, a beloved daughter through the baptism. We renewed our baptismal promises and we were confirmed in faith through the sacrament of confirmation. Today, can we remember our own baptismal promises to reject Satan, all his works, and all his empty promises, than to believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit? This was what made us a new creation. Every year, we renew our baptismal promises during the East to start over again. We try to re-enter the life of grace. Now, we have entered a new year in 2021. Although we started the year with new resolutions and with fresh hopes, sometimes we drew back. We go back to our old nature that we have left behind. Today, Lord reminds us that we have to die to our old life of sin. There are all sinful habits of the past years. There are sinful memories that we need to erase. There are sinful persons and contacts that we need to get rid of. Also, there are many negative, evil attitudes and gestures that we need to leave behind. As we have started a new year, let us ponder on the baptism of our Lord. Let us immerse our past sinful life in the waters of grace. Let us die to our past sinful life. Then let us come up again with the new life that we have gained through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Now we have been sanctified by Jesus Christ. we have been redeemed by Him. Let us become a new creation because we are beloved sons and beloved daughters in God the Father.